Butterfly gonna recap this and say Gotti caught a 30 on the dime, bro.
So all y'all wanna know what happened, I'ma tell you what happened. He got smoked.
That was crazy out the game.
From Thomas P to nobody that knows body.
Hit his area with 51. Everything in the Butterfly.
When you start rapping like that?
Hey, yo. Salute to every single one of y'all that watch this content, whether religiously or in passive. Salute to Daylight and Anderson Burris. Yo, this is crazy. Anderson Burris, who had just had a battle with Swayve Sever on the Ultimate Rap League, it turned out to be the worst battle of the night, but we'll get into that in a second. Daylight, after the battle, was very vocal about Anderson Burris, his perspective, and he needs to be gone. We don't need this over here on this side of the street. Daylight also admitted that in his career, he's had a lot of antics. He's done dumb shit. Everybody has, for myself included. We've all done something foolish. But at the end of the day, if you're able to grow and continue to build and do things the right way and move with the right perspective, you know, it is what it is. So he said that we need to get him the out of here. He has no business over here. He needs to go back across the street to, you know, whether it be King of the Dot, another league, this ain't it for him. And I said specifically that Anderson Burris, he's very talented as far as with the videos, the clips, and being able to put things together. And I notice it from a videographer's perspective, doing blogs and cutting up my own footage and editing and like that. I notice how talented he is, you know what I'm saying? He has a dope talent in doing that. Matter of fact, I'll speak about that in a second. Peep this right here.
Just want to say, get the Anderson nigga the fuck out of here. All the way the fuck out of here. No. Anderson, don't make no blog to me saying anything with, you know, Daylight said my name. And no, don't do nothing, my nigga, because I make it hard for you to ever come to any event ever again. So don't even reply to this. Just take it as it is, and we gonna get you the fuck out the culture.
What's up, Daylight? You know, I've been a fan of you since you battled Locksmith back on Grind Time. I'm a little teapot, rock, paper, scissors. Absolutely incredible. But you listen to me, Devon. Just because I'm saying some nice things about you right now, I hope you don't feel obligated to say anything nice about me, all right? I don't want to hear any response video from you going, oh, Anderson Burris said some nice things about me. No. You just sit tight, homie, all right? I'm going to give you these flowers. And if I even hear a rumor that you've been saying anything nice towards me, I will make it even easier for you to go to a battle rap event. Let's say you land somewhere in Wisconsin and you need a ride from the airport to your hotel. You hit me up, I will pay for your Uber. I got a gift card for Christmas and I've been dying to use it. And if I find out this event is in North Carolina, you better forget about a hotel, homie. You are staying at Air A&B. I already have a blow up air mattress. It's already blown up, ready for you to use. Do not test me, Devon. You have no idea how convenient I can make your life. But I do have to take real issue with one thing you said in that video. You suggested that I got 3-0'd by Swayve Sever. Okay, Swayve Sever did not 3-0 me. He 4-0'd me. He bodied me in that face-off. Are you kidding me? Okay, look, you can criticize me however you want. I don't care. But I will not stand by and let you downplay the career performance that we saw from Swayve Sever this past weekend. And I got news for you, homie. Swayve Sever was around long before Daylight. I don't mean you, by the way. I mean like literal Daylight. Swayve's like billions of years old. Okay, but he's a legend just like you, and I wish y'all nothing but the best. Thank you for watching.
So he has a talent in editing film and being able to do promotional blogs and stuff like that. But I said, if you're going to be in battle rap, you have to be good at battle rap and rapping. Like, you have to deliver on the stage. Just being able to do dope clips and edits and things like that ain't going to cut it unless you're going to be a blogger. Now, you'll be a dope blogger because you ain't got to rap. You ain't got to battle. You can just talk about battles and that be the end of it. But in your position, you're trying to battle and you want to be respected and you want to be on the biggest stage ever. So that comes with whether it be criticism, admonishment, approval, applause, and people showing love, or it just comes down to what Daylight said, where he's like, no, we're not doing this, he gotta go. Now, Daylight feels like that because he's feeling like, you know, Anderson Burris is like one of the employees' children, bring your kid to work day, and you know, it ain't like that. Like, he battled Swayve. The battle with Swayve was the worst battle on the card. And it's not just one-sided, but the thing is, at this point in his career, we already know what to expect from Swave. It's not a knock, it's no disrespect, but I've seen him for the last 15 years. I know what to expect. He's gonna have some battles where he's gonna have a super crazy performance like he did versus Tank the Demon, and you know, other joints that he's had sprinkled here and there where he's gonna wild out. Then he's gonna have some other battles where it's gonna sound like he wrote his material on the way there. Once again, I said I know what to expect from him. I have a lot of respect for what he does, so I know what to expect. Anderson Burris, this is your first shot on your first card. Everything else that you did on like the Crucible, listen, that shit don't count. When you are in college playing ball, it's cool. We'll glimpse at college ball, but we don't care about college ball. The NBA is what matters. Ja Morant went to Murray State. We don't care about what he did at Murray State. It matters in the NBA. They're winning. He's wilding with the Grizzlies right now. This is what I'm saying. Like, college don't matter. Crucible and all that little shit like that, we don't give a fuck about that. Not the niggas in the barbershops, not the niggas in the street. We not even tuning into that shit, period. It is what it is, unless somebody goes fucking crazy. Because I heard people like, oh, his battle versus J2 was fuck. Nigga, I ain't see that. I ain't see that, and I'm not going back to see it. Why? Like, I'm not watching that shit, period. What the fuck I look like? No. So, you're in the biggest league now. You're on the biggest stage, you're on the biggest platform, you're the biggest people talking about you, the biggest bloggers, the biggest everything is going to be talking about you, covering your career step by step, day by day. You have to kill it in the ring, in battle rap, you have to kill it. You have to be able to bring, yo, I tweeted before your battle happened, that you got about 15, 20 minutes to prove yourself right and all your naysayers wrong, or to just be very, very average. And after that battle, I'm not gonna lie, even though, you know, the polls got you winning and all that, it was very average. I didn't know what you was talking about in the first and third round. The second round, it was cool, but we saw the angle coming from down the street because you made the video and you exposed the song and things like that. I don't want to talk about the song. I don't even want to get into it. But you put that out there first, so it was good, you know what I'm saying? Like, because you let people know, like, yo, I'm on the way. I'm coming down this street right here. This is what's about to happen. And then, boom, you hit us with the angle. You had a good angle about it. You rapped good about it. That was great. But you're not going to be able to do that to everybody. Everybody don't got songs like that. You know what I'm saying? Everybody don't got that kind of shit in their closet where you can bring it out and expose it in the battle. It's not going to work. But one thing I will suggest, stay away from dudes like B-Dot. Stay far away from dudes like, you don't want to battle no B-Dots, you don't want to battle no JCs after what he just did versus Sharon. There's a lot of MCs that you just want to stay away from. You can stay in that funny lane, the jokey lane, the, oh, you know what I'm saying? You can stay in that lane right there. That's a good little pocket for you, bro. But the niggas who really, really get busy and serious and that will try to embarrass your whole perspective, you don't want to go nowhere near them. But there have been a lot of white people in the URL who have been successful. Mike P's had his level of success. Iron Solomon is one of the most successful ever. Sharon just came back. You know what I'm saying? There's mad others too. Snow was around for a quick minute and things like that. So it's not like it's impossible, but Daylight is just getting at the geeky, geeky, you know, substitute t-shirt vibe that you're giving off. And your video response to him was mad funny. And we knew it was going to be, you know what I'm saying? You did a dope thing with that. You had a great, you know, I got an Uber gift card that I've been dying to use and things like that. That's great. We know that that's going to be your lane, but it's not about just your lane. It's about, you know, being able to be nice. And at the end of the day, being nice, having bars, being able to break people down and being able to body that is over everything. Being somebody that people want to see is above everything. People can have their notions about you and or how they feel and all that. That doesn't matter. But being nice, you got to be nice. Like, you jumped in with a Mike P, you got to let your white friend talk to the police. Fire. But it's only one line. It was a dope moment. One of the probably top 10 moments of last year. It was fire. But you can't come back from that to what you just did here. Like, that's not gonna fly out of a lot of airports. So the battle came out. Look at the battle. When the battle first come out, when you press play, I press play by accident on the app. All the comments, trash, trash, trash. I'll be back for the next battle. Yo, I can't believe this. Why they drop? You don't want that. If you cook it, they booking. They put you on a super fight. There's a lot of guys. There's a lot of Gluezies, franchises, Riders, Reaperels, a lot of guys who are not getting called and put on those cards. They're looking at you like, what the fuck is this? I've been busting my ass for 2, 3, 4, 5 years and I'm not getting a call for these cards, and you are in a privileged position to learn a thing or two, Hoyt. Keep your mouth shut and your eyes open. And don't talk unless you're spoken to. Go ahead and hit this. Like you training day, my nigga. Officer Hoy, you're in a privileged position. But you gotta get busy in your battles. Or you're gonna have people like Daylight, who said what he said. He's not the only one that feels that way. He's the only one that's came out and said it. You don't want people lining up at your battles with pitchforks and fire like that little Simpsons joint trying to get you up out of here. But I think you'll be all right, man. We'll see where it goes, man. Salute to you and everything that you do. You know what I'm saying? Gang, gang.